finish it.
No, I don't want to.
Why?
Now
you want to eat my bread. Why are you eating my food?
Shush.
Huh?
Fat butt.
Oh my god. It's biting my butt. Hi guys. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Guys, I'm supposed to have posted a YouTube video. Like, I've already edited the video. And yesterday King was crying because he has stomach cramps, you know, this normal children's stomach cramps, right? And you know that cry can make you go confused, can make you don't even know what you're thinking about. I don't know how I mistakenly deleted the video that I was gonna post on YouTube. After discovering that I deleted that video, I want to cry. I'm like, what is all this? So please, you guys should just bear with me. I have put him to sleep, okay? And let me seize this opportunity and make the video. And I brought out soup. I'm gonna soup. Oh my god!
Just milk.
Yeah. With your big stomach. Which milk? This one. I'll just wash this few dishes before I make the swallow so that I can just enjoy my swallow. I know some of you will be wondering what happened to my arm here, right? The last time I was bathing my baby in the video. Yeah, you guys saw the scar, right? Yes, this happened to me when I was in Lagos, living with my late uncle and his wife. That was 2011. Hot water poured on me. I was climbing the stairs with a kettle of boiled water that I was gonna give my uncle to shower. So I mistakenly slipped while climbing the stairs, because the house is a duplex, okay? I mistakenly slipped from the stairs and the kettle flew, and then I fell down so hard that I have to hit my waist on the stairs, and then the water poured on me. Even here, poured on me like this, guys. Even if I open my clothes like this, you will see most of the scars like this from here up. But thank God it did not touch my boobs. But you know, the most annoying part is that my uncle and his wife, they did not take me to the hospital to treat me. They treated me at home. My auntie's an accountant. Eh? She treated me at home. They were pouring engine oil and this, and they got banana whatever, banana plants, banana leaf or banana root, I don't know what it's called. So they were squeezing the water on the burn. Guys, it was so hot that day. It was so painful. Like, I just imagined hellfire. I said, nothing will make me to go to hell by the grace of God. Nobody should go to hellfire. So, guys, had it been there, took me to the hospital, I think this keloid wouldn't have been there, right? It would have been just like this. But they did not. But it's okay. It's okay. I'm well. Did not pour on my breast. I'm good. So that was what happened to my M, okay? And there's this thing I want to discuss with you all. It's called Rh incompatibility. It is a protein found outside the red blood cell, okay? If the protein is present, that means the person is Rh positive. And if the protein is absent, that means the person is Rh negative. In the blood group, we have four types: the A, the B, the AB, and the O, right? I'm guessing at this A, B, AB, and O, and then they have A positive, A negative, B positive, B negative, AB positive, AB negative, and O positive, O negative, making eight types, right? So some people are actually positive and some are negative. I am negative. I am A negative. So that negative happens to be a problem when women are pregnant, okay? So it is advisable when a woman is pregnant, she should go for prenatal checkup. She should see her doctor, because some people are nonchalant about going to the doctor. So if you are positive, there's no problem with that. okay? But when you are negative, that is when you should see your doctor. Because I'm A negative, so the doctor has to inject Rogam, okay? Anti-D injection to me at my 28 weeks of pregnancy. And then after the delivery, they have to check the blood group of the baby. If the baby is positive, they have to give you another Rogam after 72 hours of delivery. But if the baby is negative and you are also negative, no problem. My first pregnancy, I did not get Rogam even though I'm A negative. I don't know about it. Maybe the doctor did not come up with it because it's a first baby, and maybe because first pregnancies, no problem with first pregnancies, but the problem comes with second pregnancies and onward. So it's better you should know your blood group, know when to see your doctor when you are pregnant. And you know, if you don't take all those injections, it will cause anemia, jaundice, and some severe brain damages to the baby. And it's not good. The baby might be a sickler. Not good, guys. And don't forget, Rhesus factor is different from genotype. So for some of you, don't be confused. If you are confused, you Google it, you browse it. Okay? So that is what I want to share with you.
Thank you, my love.
Mixing the dry ingredients, so now you can put your margarine. Make sure your hands are clean and then you mix. Make sure you mix them thoroughly. After mixing it, it will look like this, like a goosey, and then you break your egg. Add milk, but I think this I bought only one milk, so I think it's not gonna be enough. So I will be adding little water. So guys, after mixing it, you cover it with plastic or something else while you prepare the mix, okay? I sliced this meat because it's not sliced and because I'm not using minced meat. So guys, the frying pan is hot now. You just add a little oil. So after frying the onion for some time, you add the minced meat. So while the chicken is frying, so baby's clothes are washed. So guys, I'm gonna go spread this and then go back and check the look. I'm done spreading the laundry. So right now, we pour the potatoes. Add your carrot. I don't have fresh pepper, so I'm gonna add this one. Even though it's not hot. Your Maggi stock. My thyme leaves. Some black pepper. And curry. Some salt. And then you cover to cook. So guys, I'm already preheating my oven. See? Some margarine so the meat pie will not stick in the pan. This is cooked, so I'll be adding some flour to it to make it thicker. And it's ready. So guys, I'm using this bottle because I don't have the wallet. Should look like you place it in your buttered tray. Right, as you can see, I'm done. So you just get one egg. Rub it here so it doesn't open, and then it will give it a nice look. Just poke it. So that stem can go inside and it will be completely. Then you put it in the middle of the oven. 50 minutes, time is 50 minutes and temperature of 175 degrees Celsius. Okay guys, so guys, I'm done baking. My husband has eaten one already. Remember, temperature 175 degrees Celsius. See how it looks like. Yummy. Thank you guys for watching. Bye.